Hey guys, how do you do? Welcome to Asian Programming Wiz. Now, for today, we're continuing with course with the Vue.js tutorials. Today, we're going to see how to work with a material, a design bottom bar right here. Okay, so you can see, of course, first at the top we have our toolbar, then at the bottom we have our bottom bar right here, then we have our content section. So, this is simple, just displaying this particular bottom bar items, and then of course handling the item clicks. So for instance, if you click recent, you can see a nice animation, and then of course alert dialog also gets displayed right here. Okay, so of course you can make use of this one on click and maybe open a page or something like that. Is this simple? This is what we're going to be doing right here, a material design bottom bar. So by the way, we have of course the tutorial right here, the material view bottom bar. We already have it of course in the text format in our website composure.info, so you can just navigate over to it right here. And of course we have the guide right here, a brief introduction, and then of course we're going to need some dependencies. Okay, we'll need dependencies. By the way, we're going to be using the codepen.io. It's an online IDE. We're going to be developing our JavaScript applications right there. It's advantageous in that I can easily share code with you guys, and then also we don't have to install anything. Okay, we can simply fetch a libraries via CDN. So first we're going to need these particular CSS libraries, now the three of them. Of course, first we have our Vue material.css right here, because we're using the material design. Okay, so we have it right here, Vue material. CSS. We also have of course our material icons. We're fetching them from googleapis.com. Then we also have the font family right here. We're also fetching it from the same site. Apart from those ones, we're going to need two JavaScript libraries right here. First of course we have the vue.main.js. Now this is the core vue.js library that we're going to be using. So we're fetching it from a CDN. Then we also have the Vue material. We fetch the latest, okay, from this particular CDN site. That's it. If you want to download the full source code, just come right here, click. It's a direct link. You're going to have the source code. Otherwise, you can come right here. You can, of course, have a look at our demo. You can see we have the HTML, we have the CSS, so we have the JavaScript right here. Now, this, of course, is our stuff right here that we're going to be making. So the first thing that you guys need you guys to do, just come right here and then click edit on CodePen. This is going to open for us of course our editor, so you guys can go ahead and then fork the project and then of course edit it right here. The first thing, we come of course in our HTML section right here. We need to add those particular CDN libraries that I showed you guys. So come right here to the CSS, then of course add them. Okay, we can see right here our font family, also the material icons, as well as the view material.css. Add them right here in the CSS section. Then of course come right here in the JavaScript section, also add the vue.main.js as well as the view material right here. Just add them right here. It shall get fetched of course from our CSS. Okay, so this is it. This is of course our IDE right here that you're going to be using. So you can see we have three sections, the HTML section, the CSS, as well as the JavaScript. In our CSS, we're just making sure that we give our content a padding of 20 pixels. Then we come right here. Now, inside our div tag, in fact, everything we're wrapping right here in our div tag, okay? Then, of course, in our JavaScript, the first thing, we're going to be using the Vue material library. So vue.use, Vue material. Then, of course, we instantiate our Vue. So app equal to new view, we're going to pass in an object. Which element are we targeting? Well, of course we're targeting this app ID, this div tag right here. Okay, then of course we're simply going to have one method that you're going to be using. It's a greet method. It's a function. It's taking in a variable we're calling message right here. Then of course it shows that particular variable in an alert dialog. So we come right here via app ID. Then of course we first have our toolbar right here with the title, of course right here you can see. Let me change it. In fact, we can just change it right here, bottom bar. Okay, material view bottom bar. Then you can see it gets reflected. It auto loads itself right here, then of course gets reflected. Then of course that's of course in our toolbar is at the top. Then of course we also have right here our content section. Okay, we have of course the toolbar section, we have the content section, and then we also have of course at the bottom bar that you're going to be using. So for the content section, you guys can see right here that we of course have our content right here. I just have some dummy text right here that you're going to be using. This is in our content section. Then of course in our bottom bar, I've given it bottom bar ID. Then we have our bottom bar. Let me just expand this one to make it better. Okay, so bottom bar right here, we have of course our bottom bar items. So bottom bar, then bottom bar item right here, we give it the history icon. Then of course reasons. Now take note of this one, at click.native, then we call the grid function. What we're saying, if the user clicks the recent this recent of course bottom bar item, we're going to of course call the function grid. Okay, then of course you're passing in this text recent right here. This is the text that shall get displayed then of course in our alert dialog. Then of course we also have this next one, the favorites, then also the last one, also the nearby. You can see this is how we handle our item clicks. Okay, at click.native, then we call the function that you'd like. That's it guys. We can then go ahead and then save. Then you guys can come right here, go to the full page mode. For me, given that I'm logged in, I can move over to the debug mode, and then of course we can have a look at our app right here. If I click, you can see reasons. Then if I click right here, favorites, then of course if I click right here, of course the nearby. This is it guys, this is it. This is what we've looked at right here, bottom bar in Vue.js. Stay tuned for more Vue.js tutorials. If you guys haven't subscribed, make sure you guys subscribe so you don't miss any of our tutorials. Otherwise, take care. I'll catch you in the next class.